Nous venons de lire juste le livre de Matthieu, chapitre 17, de 1 à 9. Et le thème de notre prédication, Matthieu, la vie soit de l'homme, à sa qu'on a vu ce qu'on a, Jésus, l'inégalable. Alléluia.
Amen.
Yesu, oya kukanina motote. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, equal to now. Amen. Autre temps, il y a un fact. It's not a dream. But it's a fact. It's a reality. It's something that's happened. Alleluia.
Amen.
It's not this story. It's not something that somebody make it up. No. It's a reality. Alleluia.
Amen.
Yesu azalaki elongo na bayekoli. Lokola momesano. Me komaki na tango azwaki misato. Akendeki na bango, abimaki na bango. Alleluia.
Amen.
They were all together. They were sharing time together. But it came to a time where Jesus called only three of them and took them apart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he went to them to the mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yesu ameni bango na ngomba. Actually, it's something I would like to preach very deeply, but because of time, I will not be able to do it. I will just pick some points. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But
Amen.
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 Jésus a mis à mon angomba. Abengi batumi satu o bazalaki ba apostolo. Kati na le 12.
Ben a biso azangi elo kote azali nzambe ya makoki nyonso.
God is so good. God is so good. And all the time. And all the time. The Bible says after 6 days, Jesus was with the apostles.
Yesu azalaki na bayekoli na ye.
But at once, he left the 9.
Atiki bango.
And he just took 3.
He
just took and take them to the mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And he took Peter.
As we Peter.
James.
As we
Jacques.
Jacques.
And John.
As we now Jean.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't know why Jesus took only these three. But there is something special. Hallelujah. Because this is not the first time he took them. It's not the last time he took them. Always when something is special, Jesus will call us free and take them apart. Hallelujah. Sometimes Jesus went with them.
Yes,
when he went to pray, he always took them. At this day also, Jesus took them to the mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But one thing we know. In Israel. In Israel. There were two important mountains. One of them is Zion. And the next one is Hermon Mountain. Hallelujah. But this day, Jesus took them to the Hermon Mountain. Hallelujah. I want you to follow me.
Ruth,
are you okay with us? Amen. This day, he took them to the mountain. But it was not the Zion mountain. But it was the Hermon mountain. Hallelujah. At the mountain. The mountain is very important for the kingdom of God.
Sorry,
I've been more than
6 years
or 7 years in preaching English.
Hallelujah.
That'll be hard for
you.
I believe you are going to get something.
Hallelujah.
Okay?
It's a good call and down.
Amen.
Amen.
In the mountain, Jesus stopped changing. They saw him changing. But they were in the mountain. In the Hermon Mountain. Let me tell you, there was two important mountains in Israel. First one is Hermon Mountain. And this is the mountain where Jesus took them. And the second mountain is Zion. And let me tell you the secret of those two mountains. God is in heaven. Hallelujah. And when God wants to bless you,
so
he will send the rain. The rain is the blessings for you. But when this rain can come down from the throne of grace, he will get down to the mountain Hermon. Hallelujah. That is Hermon Mountain. Is the mountain that receives from God.
Ngomba oyo epesame la Nzambe.
Ngomba oyo ezwaka kuhute pa na Nzambe.
Oyo ezwaka kuhute pa na Nzambe.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anything God wants to send for you,
eliko nyonso Nzambe leko tinga pona yo,
deliver it. God will deliver it. And this thing
is
going to come to the mountain Hermon. And when the mountain Hermon get it, it will send it to the Zion Mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Zion
Mountain
that will do the distribution for everybody. God don't give you directly.
God don't
give directly to the Zion Mountain.
Zambe apesa mbaramoko na Zion Mountain.
The position of Zion Mountain is to give to distribute whatever God has sent.
Ezali pona kokabola o nyonso kolo atende.
But Hermon Mountain,
kasi ngomba ya Hermon,
receive from God.
Azwaka epai na kolo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That when something that is receiving from God,
eloko o enzwami na maboko na Nzambe,
is in a higher position than Zion Mountain.
Ezali likolo koleka ngomba ya Zion.
Hallelujah. At this day, Jesus took them to the Hermon Mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because he wanted to do something.
But
the Bible says, he just took Peter,
Pietro,
James,
Jacques,
and John. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And if you see there, the way Jesus called all the apostles, you're
going to
find out that he started also with them. They were the first that Jesus called. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And
Anything, whatever, anything happened, it will call them apart. Jesus was preparing them from something. Hallelujah. Amen. At this day, he took them to the mountain. Amen. You know when you go to the mountain, what do you find? Only rocks. Hallelujah. In the mountain you find the rocks. But when you anywhere you find the rocks, it's possible to find also precious stones. Precious stones. Hallelujah. Like diamond. All those stuff.
Hallelujah.
Any richness that comes from God and that gave to men, he hid it in a mountain. Amen. And God, Jesus, took them to the mountain. And the mountain is a place of blessing. That's why you always will see Jesus. He will go time and time to the mountain
to pray.
Because in the mountain there are rocks and stones. And the Bible says Jesus is our rock. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Himself is a rock. He took them to the mountain where you find the rock. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That means he went himself to his own house. The mountain is Jesus himself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He took them to the mountain. The Bible is telling us Jesus Christ is the rock. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know where you were born? When you were created, God took you from the dust. Adam was the dust. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But Jesus never was the dust. Jesus is the stone. Amen. That's why when you die,
When you die
in Christ,
I'm not talking about physical death.
When you die in Jesus, you become a new creature. A new creature is a time of change. It's a process of transformation. You come from the dust and you change to become a rock. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want you to see that. You were a dust. God took you in the ground. But once you accept Jesus, once you become son of God, God
will
change you. God transform you from the dust to become a rock. Hallelujah. That means the mountain is a rock. But the mountain is a Jesus. Because Jesus is the rock. Hallelujah. But once you become born again, Hallelujah. Because you are not dust anymore. You are not clay anymore. You become a rock. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the church is a mountain. Hallelujah. The church is a mountain. Because when you go to any land, and you see a mountain, you're going to see the difference. Because the mountain is a higher place. And you cannot hide the mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You cannot hide the mountain.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That means the mountain, anywhere is a mountain, everybody must see it.
Hallelujah.
That's why the church is a mountain. mountain.
Because
you are in a higher place. You should not be down there. You should not be in the lower position. Because you are a mountain. The church should be up there. And everybody must see it. You cannot hide the church. Because the church is a mountain. You don't hide the mountain.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But what happened when the people see us? What they see in us? Because anybody see a mountain, whatever you are Christian or not, you're going to see the mountain.
But the mountain is a mountain.
You see a mountain, you don't need to be spiritual. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anybody see a mountain? Anybody see a church? But when they observe the church, when they find the church, when they find in us as a mountain, can they look at us? Can they follow us? What example we are setting up for the world? That's why the church is a mountain. When the church is a mountain, that means the church is a mirror. Hallelujah. Where people can see the face of Jesus. You are a mirror. People
are
supposed to see Jesus in
you.
People are supposed to see Jesus in us.
Yes.
That's why I took them to the mountain. That's why Jesus always went to pray to the mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because in the mountain he feel home at home.
Amen.
Amen. You know in football. I want to provoke Taj. You know in football. When you are playing home, you feel more stronger.
So
Hallelujah. Home, you feel well.
Amen.
You know, people in boxing, people go in German, they always lose. Hallelujah. But to the German, out of Germany, take them anywhere else. They will not win. Because the Germans at home, they are always strong.
Amen.
That's why Jesus always went to the mountain to pray.
Amen.
The
Hermon
Mountain is for you to be blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your blessing must transit from the Hermon Mountain.
Before you
reach you.
At the way
there, Jesus was there with them.
Suddenly,
his face started changing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They call this mountain is Hermon Mountain. But after this event, people start calling it Mountain of Transfiguration. Hallelujah. Transfiguration.
Transfiguration.
Always the word trans.
The lobaya trans
mean disconnect from somewhere to go somewhere else. Or a movement from one place to another place. Or a change from one aspect to another aspect. Hallelujah. And when they talk about transfiguration, that means his face start changing. And they saw the face of Jesus. They knew Jesus. The way with Jesus always. They knew his face. But this day they saw the change in him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to my God.
Hallelujah.
That's why they call this Mountain of Transfiguration.
Because
he changed his face.
Hallelujah. Amen.
And when he changed his face, they saw Moses and Elijah. They came and they start talking to Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were there. And they saw Jesus. Because they knew Jesus. And they saw Moses. They never met Moses. But because they was apostles, they had a spiritual connection. They understood this is Moses. They were not necessary somebody to tell them that this is Moses. This connection that they have in the spirit.
This is Moses.
And the other one is Elijah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 But when the soul, three of them talking, they were afraid. Because they knew Moses is gone long time ago. Elijah has gone long time ago. Hallelujah. Elijah, he never died. God took him alive. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the second person God took alive. The first was Enoch. God took Enoch. Then secondly, God came and took Elijah. Alive. Hallelujah. And the third one is Moses. Moses died. But God didn't want the people of Israel to bury Moses in the land. Because God knew if they bury Moses here, they will make him a god. They will be worshipping
Moses.
And Moses will become like an idol for them. That's why God took his body. Hallelujah. God took his body entirely, his body went. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why God did
that?
Because God did know that one day he's going to use this tool to come and to bear witness for Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the time of tribulation,
these
two apostles,
they
will come alive to witness about Jesus in the last time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But why did they come in this day to be with Jesus?
Because
it's a reason. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They saw Jesus and Moses and Elijah. They were talking. And Peter looked at them. They were confused. Hallelujah. You know, before this happened, they were somewhere. Jesus told them that soon I will be gone. Soon I will be dying. I will pass away. Hallelujah. But 6 days after this conversation, he took them to that mountain. And they saw Jesus with Elijah and Moses. And they were more confused. That's why Peter, he came and asked,
Lord,
we want to build three chapels. We want to build three temples. For one for you, one for Elijah, one for Moses. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They knew Jesus was their Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But now, because they saw Elijah, and they want to build houses for them. But Jesus already told them that soon I will be gone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because they didn't have a revelation of the cross. Of the cross.
Hallelujah.
That's why they were telling Jesus, no, let us be here. They wanted Jesus to be their own property. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lot of times, I think three or three times, Peter was confused. He wanted to keep Jesus with him, to be just for him forever. But he didn't understand that Jesus came for the world, not just for him. Hallelujah. That's why he's telling him, we want to build the free houses for you, that we may be here, we may live here. Hallelujah. Amen. That means he was telling, he was trying to take Jesus out of his mission. Jesus came for a mission. Jesus came to rescue you and me. Jesus didn't come to stay in the mountain and make his life in the mountain. No. Hallelujah. Peter was confused. Then you know what happened? After that, they heard a voice coming from heaven. They heard a voice. Hallelujah. They heard a voice. Let me read my Bible. This is the second time. This is the second time the voice came from heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The first time, when Jesus was baptized. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When Jesus was baptized, the voice came from heaven. And the second time, was in the book of John. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People came. They were trying to arrest Jesus. And when they were discussing to arrest Jesus, or to stone him, voice came from heaven. That was the second time. And this one, today, is the third time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The first time is, you can find it in Matthew 3.
In 17.
And the second one is in John 12. 28. And the third one is this one.
Matthew 17.
Now we have problem here. Because the first time is in the book of Matthew. The third time also in the book of Matthew. But the second time is in the book of John. Even though it's from different books. But according to the chrono, the time of God, the event of from the book of John was the second time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't be confused about that. The first time, the voice came from the book of Matthew. The second time, from the book of John. The third time, they came back this day. Amen.
Amen.
But let me tell you, any time that was confusion, God need to speak. You know why? When Jesus was about to be baptized, John the Baptist was confused.
John Baptist was in confusion
because he didn't know who is Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. John the Baptist was confused.
John Baptist was in confusion.
He knew Jesus because they were cousins. He knew Jesus when they were in the belly, in the tummy. When Mary, the mother of Jesus, went to visit Elizabeth, the mother of
John,
and Elizabeth was 6 months pregnant.
Elizabeth was 6 months.
Hallelujah. But when Mary entered the house, and the children, both of them, they did a spiritual connection. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why when Mary entered the house of Elizabeth, and the child that was John the Baptist, and the belly shook. He moved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because of that connection.
Bon, connection.
But physically, they never meet physically.
Mais physique, ma, ba,
John didn't know Jesus physically.
Jean a ébaki Yesu physiquement.
He didn't know how Jesus looked like. He didn't
know. A ébaki ke Yesu asali lorenge ni.
But he knew that God has sent him.
Kasayeba ye nzambe asi
a. To open the way for Jesus.
E ko fungula nzela.
But he didn't know who is Jesus.
Kasayeba ke
how he looked like.
Asali
de. And he was a little bit confused.
Asala ki na confusion kuche na kati na.
Amen. And God gave him a sign.
Nzambe a pe
sele. For you to know Jesus, the day will come to you.
Mokolo
the Spirit of the living God will come to him as a son of
dove.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the sign God gave him.
He never knew
how Jesus looked like. He was a little bit confused. That's why the day he baptized Jesus, God has to give testimony to John the Baptist to take away all the confusion. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are confused too.
You also.
Hallelujah. You go to the church, but you don't know why you go to church. You go to church, you don't know who you are following.
Because
John was confused like you and me.
Oh,
John, we are part of the church. We are members of the church. We are even pastors. But we don't have a connection with Jesus. That's why we are confused.
There
are so many pastors, they become Jesus themselves. Hallelujah. Glory be to my God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
After he baptized Jesus,
he
saw the lamb coming down. Then he heard a voice. This voice was for nobody else.
Just for John the Baptist.
Tell him, this one is my son. You heard about him. I told you about him. I said you can open the way for him. But today, I'm giving you the son. This is my son, to whom I love so much. You need to listen to him. Hallelujah. This one, the first time the voice came from. And the second time, it was in the book of John. And the voice came for the people. Because there were many of them. But they were confused. Because Jesus was telling them, they were trying to find, are you a Messiah? They were trying to find, are you a Messiah? Hallelujah.
Amen.
They didn't know if Jesus is a Messiah or not. They went to see Jesus.
Sorry.
They went to see John the Baptist. Tell us who you are. Are you a Messiah?
John said,
I'm not a prophet. I'm just the voice of the
desert.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they went to see Jesus.
And
they asked Jesus, we went to see your cousin.
John.
We asked him if he's the Messiah.
He
said he's not the Messiah. Now, because you are doing wonders, you tell us yourself if you are a Messiah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were confused. They wanted to find out about the Messiah.
That when
God has to talk to them, the voice has to come to tell them that this is my son.
This is the one I said.
So here you're going to be saved.
Hallelujah.
The first time the heaven spoke to John the Baptist. The second time, the heaven spoke to the crowd to tell them that this is my son. This is the Messiah. This is the Savior of the world.
I'm
believing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you are confused. You don't know who is your Savior. Hallelujah.
Amen.
On Sunday, I was sharing something. I know some church.
By English,
I know one church.
English,
they got many goddesses.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you read in the Bible,
they
read God. Who made you and me? God is a spirit. And the spirit never
dies.
I'm telling you, a spirit never
dies.
That's why, as a pastor,
we are
not allowed to kill demons.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When you kill demons because they are spirit, they're not supposed to die.
So
you
are bombing Molimo, Locola is a Molimo,
you
are Parce que
God never called us to kill demons. Because they are spirits.
Spirits
never die. Whatever bad or good. Amen.
Amen.
But there is a condition when we need to kill
demons.
But not always that we do. And you need to know in which condition.
And
I don't want to tell you that. If anybody wants to know about it,
so he wants to know about it, he will give you the secret.
Glory to my God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus,
yes,
is our Savior. And when you are God,
so
you're not supposed to die. You cannot die. You're never gonna die. That's why Jesus never died. But I know in church, they got long list of goddess. The Father was God, died. The Son came to become the God of the church. The Son, 2 years, 4 years, died. His brother came to take a place. And the said, is not God, then he would have died. Hallelujah. Then every child of this died. Now the grandson become also a God.
And they
keep dying because they are not truthful God. A truthful God never dies. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why Jesus,
Jesus
was as he was God. They forced us to come down to tell them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the third time they
heard
is this day. Because the apostle also, they were confused too. Even though they were with Jesus, they saw wonders. But they were confused. They never understood Jesus. They were thinking Jesus is going to be the king of Israel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they were thinking that when Jesus becomes a king, they're going to be ministers. They were thinking that Jesus' country is Israel. But Jesus was telling them about the kingdom of heaven.
Hallelujah.
Jesus was telling them, I'm not the king of this earth. I'm the king of the land of my God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Because they were confused. One day they knew he's a Messiah.
The
next day, Jesus told them he will die.
How can
the Messiah die? If he's
going to
die, that is not you. Hallelujah. But he's going to ask Jesus. That's why they were confused. And God knew that they were confused. That's why for the third time, a voice must come from heaven to tell them. Hallelujah. Do you see the picture? It's a free time that the voice came from heaven. This day is for them, for the apostles. They were Jesus' friends. But they were confused. They didn't know Jesus.
Really.
That's why the voice came. He is him. Because from him
comes
the joy of my heart.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And we as the church,
Église,
we are confused.
We know
the name of Jesus.
We
know about Jesus. But we don't have Jesus. Oh, we have a little Jesus. Oh, we have a small baby Jesus.
But
our Jesus is sleeping.
And
most of the time, our pastors, they become our Jesus.
And
we believe them. We follow them. Hallelujah. But one day they're gonna die. Because they are human beings. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Jesus took them to the mountain.
Bomba,
but they were confused. They were trying to compare Jesus
and Jesus
and Moses
and
Elijah. That's why they say, let us build three houses. They were putting Jesus in the same level as Moses. They were putting Jesus in the same level as Elijah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Moses was a prophet of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Moses was prophet of God. God used Moses to bring the law in the earth. The law.
Amen.
Moses represents the law.
Moïse a fallu pour représenter le béco.
But Elijah also was a prophet of God.
Il est un prophète dans Zambé.
Et ingénieur.
Azadi.
Amen. Nous
sommes ingénieurs. Moi, l'ingénieur,
alléluia.
Amen.
Elijah was also a prophet of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But Elijah represents the prophet.
Hallelujah.
Represent the voice of
prophet.
In the time of the law.
Amen.
But Jesus has nothing to do with the law. Jesus has nothing to do with the prophet. Even though he was himself a prophet. But Jesus was not just a prophet. Jesus is more than a prophet.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Jesus is more than a prophet. Because
Abraham
wanted to see the day of Jesus. And he saw it. And he praised Jesus. And he bowed down before Jesus. He knew himself. He cannot be compared to Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
And Moses was a prophet of God. But Moses spoke about Jesus. He said himself, in the last time, God will send to you another prophet who will come from your from the tribe of David, but he will be greater than me. Hallelujah. Moses himself could not compare himself to Jesus because he knew Jesus is not just a prophet. He's more than a prophet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You cannot compare Jesus. That's what Peter was trying to do. Let us be here. We're going to enjoy the law. We're going to enjoy the prophet. By God. If God sent Jesus to go to the Calvary Mountain. To the Calvary Mountain. To die for you and me. For in order for us to be saved.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus didn't come to stay in this world.
He
came to rescue you
and I.
Then he's going to go back to his
land
where he belonged. Hallelujah. And we wanted to keep him in our corner, in our churches, in the place of our comfort.
in a place of our comfort. That's what Peter was trying to do. Let's be with Jesus
in a place of comfort,
that we will enjoy him. Just few of us. But Jesus didn't come for few of you, because he is the Son of God. He came to set the world free. He came to deliver my mama. He came to deliver my dada. He came to set the church free. He came to deliver you and I. That's why Jesus is not just a prophet, but he's more than a prophet. Because any prophet you know in the world, they have their mothers, but one day they will be dead. One day they will not die. But Jesus, he went to the Mount of Calvary. He died on the Calvary. He died on the cross. But he stayed on it 3 days.
Hallelujah.
After 3 days, the Bible says,
God raised him.
And he came
alive.
It's no story. It's no dream.
It's an dream.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
People saw him.
But
they sit down with him. They eat with him. It's no makeup story.
It's a story.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Like we made up many stories of many prophets.
Prophet appeared
to me, told me. Who told you is him? Hallelujah. Every prophet in the world.
Prophet in your
family. They have their tombs. And when you go there, you find the name written there, and the bones are inside. But Jesus is the only one who have a tomb, but the tomb is empty. Why? Because of you and me. Because he wanted to set you free. Hallelujah. Because he came to take away your problems. He came to take away your disease. Hallelujah. He came to set you free. Set you out of confusion. Because we are confused. We don't know who we are following. We don't know who we are serving. We don't know who is the real Jesus. Because John Baptist was confused. Because the apostles, they were confused. Because the crowd also were confused. But you as a church of God, the Bible said you are a rock. The Bible said you are the mountain. A mountain is a strong place. A mountain is a solid place. Nothing can move the mountain. If only the prayer of Jesus. Hallelujah. Strong, because God has set you free. Because our Jesus is not like
Mohammed.
He's not like Buddha.
He's
not like Simon Paddy.
He's
not like Simon Kimbado.
He's
not like Simon Toko.
He's
not like Papa Onda.
All
they are just men. The Bible says in the time of Samuel. God was speaking rarely. I want you to get the revelation. In the time of
Samuel,
God is speaking rarely. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And in the Bible, after the judges, God was not speaking. You see in your Bible, the Old Testament, the New Testament, you see empty page in your Bible. I want you to check your Bible. Come on, everybody check your Bible. Between the Old and the New Testament. Every Bible, come on. Be fast. You find it. Empty page
in your Bible. Entre ancien et nouveau testament,
you got it.
Somebody
who
got it.
Who else? Empty page.
A page vide.
Glory be to my God. Hallelujah. Do you know why you have this empty page? When you don't have paper.
Ceux qui ont un papier.
When you are to pick note, you
have to note or come plus one.
This is the gift they give to you.
Hallelujah.
Did you see the empty page?
Yes.
Be with me, please. Did you see the empty page?
Yes.
You know why you have this
empty page?
It's 400 years.
It's only 400 years.
Hallelujah. Allez. This empty page means 400 years.
400 ans,
God didn't speak.
Zambé a l'obate l'obate.
God never speak to the world.
Zambé
for 400 years.
400 ans. Because 400 Zambé a l'obate.
God spoke to Malachi.
Zambé a l'obate na Malachi.
Then after Malachi,
c'est Malachi.
400 years, God never spoke. That's why God is
empty.
And then God came to speak again through John the Baptist.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now you know why you have this page. It's not for you to
be
it's because God closed his mouth. He never spoke
before.
Hallelujah. Then he came to speak again through John the Baptist. And then after John the Baptist, God came himself to be with you and I and talk to us in different ways. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why when Jesus died, in the corner of God, in the crown of God, this empty page is not there where is a separation between the Old and the New Testament.
No.
Hallelujah. It was in that time, no. Because John the Baptist was a prophet of Old Testament. And Jesus himself, he lived in the time of the law, under the law. He lived in the Old Testament. Jesus bring the transition. Hallelujah. The time that separates the New and the Old Testament is where Jesus was hanging on the cross and he gave his soul to God. And the Bible said in the temple, the curtain of the temple.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Na kati ya tempo. Kisa lakini na rido. La Bible di pasuki.
Rido e pasuka na kati.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
E uti likolo.
Ko uta likolo.
From the top.
Ko banda likolo.
To the ground.
Ina se. E pasuki.
Hallelujah. And God changed his way.
Nzambe abongole.
Alobi. God say.
God say.
Banda lelo. From today. This day, the spirit that was living in the church went away from the church. Hallelujah. That's why from that day, we don't look Jesus in the mountain anymore. We don't look God in the mountain anymore. But God took place in you. Hallelujah. He lives on you. And this is the day that the Old and the New Testament are.
Ancien et Nouveau Testament est à bon.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 That's why God is talking now. Through his servants. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God will speak to you.
Amen.
Through his servants. There are many ways God used to speak to us. But one of the ways is through his servants. Hallelujah. Because you are confused. That's why God is telling me and telling you today. Using me to tell you. Jesus is the only Savior. Jesus Christ
is the only savior. The savior is not your mama. The savior is not your dad. The savior is not your pastor. The savior is not your prophet. The savior is not your apostle. The savior is not your uncle. The savior is not your bank account. The savior is not your beautiful wife. The savior is only Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And Jesus is not a prophet like any prophet you know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some prophet, we were here together.
The prophet Moses.
Next day, he was pastor. Today is pastor. Next day, he wake up, he go to Benin Republic. When he came back, he became a prophet. Hallelujah. But yesterday was pastor. That's what we see today. Amen.
Amen.
Today, I'm a pastor. When the church become big, I will not be pastor anymore. I become apostle. Hallelujah. Man can change, and they will change. But Jesus is the only one who never changed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Am